Hi, this is Aisha. We are studying chapter number 6, ICT applications. Today we will discuss about computers in medicine. So what is the use of computer in medicine? First of all, diagnostic system. Doctors cannot be expected to be an expert in every part of the medicine. A patient may not be able to explain properly about his or her disease. So for proper treatment, proper diagnosis is compulsory. So where we use CT scanners and MRI scanners allows doctors to investigate what is happening inside a patient's body without intrusive surgery. So they are just scanning without doing any surgery. The complex signals that come back from these huge machines are picked up by the sensors and fed into the computer. The computer then processes the data. Outputs can be the full color image, or sometimes it may be in 3D image. Next, computers are used for patient's record. It is essential that the medical details of every patient is recorded accurately. For this reason, hospital makes use of computerized database to store patient record. So what are the advantages of using database? Patient data can be easily shared between the doctors, pharmacies and other hospitals. It is easy to search for and retrieve patient record. Doctors can instruct a pharmacy to issue medication for a patient. What type of information can be recorded for the patient? Their ID, name, date of birth, gender, address, their previous medical history, the doctor that is currently treating him or her, current medication which he is using, X-rays or body scans, links to the images and video files can be stored, notes and the reports about the health situation and the treatment as well, and laboratory test. So this type of information can be stored about the patient. And patient record must be secure. So there is a reason for the concern about the implications of security, access and use of patient information. Why? Hacking, which could lead to the altering of patient data. Someone may hack their data and alter the patient data. Okay. Misuse of health information records by authorized user of the system. So it is compulsory to make it secure so that no one else can misuse that. The possibility of intrusion into personal healthcare matters by police, social workers or other government institutions. So that is why it is very important to keep patient data secure. Third, computers are used for the pharmacy record. Pharmacists use computers to store and process a vast amount of information. Computer systems are used to keep track of stock levels, useful for ordering and stock management, long-term stock levels, product demand data can be used to analyze demand data, the spread of infectious disease such as cold and flu outbreaks. For example, many persons are asking for the same medicine. It means you can analyze that there is a spread of this type of disease. Next, computers can be used for monitoring of patients. It is not possible for a doctor or a nurse to monitor patient continuously 24 hours a day. So computerized monitors are used instead. So what is the process? Input: sensors are attached to the patient to monitor pulse rate, temperature, BP and the breath rate. They will send the data for the processing. Data is checked for the problems and logged. Continuously checking and continuously sending for the process and logged. After that, output can be, it can show graph on the monitor. It can buzzer or alarm can be produced if something is over or lower than the pre-recorded value. And even hard copies can be printed for that data. Next one is expert system for diagnosis. Expert systems, they allow medical staff with a limited medical knowledge, for example nurse, to get advice from the computer expert. Medical staff input patients and symptoms or answer questions about them. For example, pre-recorded form is there, you just answer the question just by giving the patient symptom, okay, just by entering the patient symptom. The expert system search engine search the knowledge base. a collection of medical knowledge to find the possible diagnosis based on that symptoms which you have entered. The system outputs a list of possible diagnoses and the treatments. So all the possible diagnoses related to that will be listed out, and the treatments related to that will be listed out. There are four main things used in this expert system. Four parts are the facts about illness and the conditions, that is the knowledge base, the facts about illness and the conditions. Next, the means of asking questions and getting responses from the system, that is human computer interface. Okay, first you have to tell about the facts about the illness and the condition. You need an interface to answer the questions and to get the response from the computer. Third thing, the set of rules that data has to be abided by, that is the rule base. Okay, the set of rules the data has to be abided by. And the last thing, the program that can apply the rules in order to get sensible results. It will take the data from the knowledge base, apply the rule, and will give you the sensible results. Okay, this is known as inference engine. So these are the four main things that is used in the expert system: knowledge base, inference engines, interface, and the rule base. Next thing is computers used in the medicine, for example, 3D printers used for medical aids. Okay, 3D printers, we have already studied, it prints object, not on the paper, but the objects. So for medical aids, we can use 3D printers. It can be used in producing medical aids, for example, surgical and diagnostic aids, development of prosthetics and medical products, tissue engineering, just like you can look at this picture, artificial blood vessels, design of medical tools and equipment. So what are the advantages of using 3D printer? Printing can be faster as compared to manufacturing different parts. But what are the disadvantages? Limited selection of material available. And this 3D printing for medical aids is still in early stages. So this is all how we use computers in the medicine. Thank you very much for listening.